Hello everyone, and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short recap of what was released today, September 9th, 2025. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then I'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities that I am covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how it stacks up. With that, we have a total of 81 newly disclosed vulnerabilities. Of those 81, 22 fall into the remote code execution impact, which is a little bit lower than the 33.38 that we've been seeing over the past 13 months. Remote code execution vulnerabilities are the type of impact that typically provides the most risk. This would allow a threat actor to install software on endpoints and other high-level actions. Next, we'll move into scoring, where Microsoft uses the industry standard Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a methodology that rates vulnerabilities on a scale between 1 and 10, where 10 represents the highest level of risk. This month, the highest scored CVE comes at 9.8 on that scale of 10. The average over the past 13 months is right around 9.5. Next, I'll talk about the average score across all 81 vulnerabilities. That comes in at 7.3, which is a little bit lower than 7.45 over the past 13 months. Now, I like to use CVSS scores as a starting point when we talk about risk. It allows vendors to be able to compare and contrast vulnerabilities across their products and services, or even different vendors being able to compare different vulnerabilities on the same scale. This is calculated using 8 different vector strings: attack complexity, attack vector, privileges required, user interaction, scope, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. And once all of those different metrics are put in, we get a score that again is an industry standard methodology, but it doesn't include everything when we talk about risk. For example, it doesn't include the impact, whether it's a remote code execution vulnerability versus information disclosure vulnerability. Next, we have severity, which Microsoft uses, and we have low, moderate, important, and critical. Not all vendors use that same methodology to rate the severity, but that's not included in the CVSS score. Nor is whether or not a vulnerability is publicly disclosed or not. These are the types of vulnerabilities where one way or another, the existence of the vulnerability has been made public. It could be a threat actor or a security researcher making a social media post that they found a thing, a vulnerability, but they don't provide the details that would allow someone to build exploit code. And then on the other end, it could be full proof of concept that would allow folks to be able to build that exploit code. This month, there are two vulnerabilities that fall in the publicly disclosed category, and that's right about our average over the past 13 months of 1.92. Another thing that's not included in the CVSS score is whether or not a vulnerability has been known to be exploited at the time of release. Publicly disclosed vulnerability is kind of a theoretical risk. These are very real risks. These are where either Microsoft directly or through our partners have noticed some sort of exploitation of a vulnerability prior to release. This month, there are no vulnerabilities in the set that were known to be exploited, and that's obviously lower than our average over the past 13 months of just over 2. Okay, let's get into the September release, and we'll start with this overview chart. Those of you that have seen this video before, you'll recognize this, where we put the Windows products towards the bottom, and then we move up the chart into products that we don't necessarily service every single month. On the Windows side, we've been averaging low 50s to low 60s, depending on the specific operating system. And as we can see, we're a little bit lower than that average on a handful of the operating systems, and right in line with some of the others. So a little bit lower all up, but not too much. As we move up the chart, we get into Office, which has a handful of vulnerabilities that are being addressed this month, as well as SharePoint. There's a handful of vulnerabilities in the Azure umbrella that have vulnerabilities that are addressed in this month's set of updates. And rounding it all off, there are vulnerabilities in SQL Server that are addressed by updates in today's release. All right, the first vulnerability that I'll talk to today is CVE-2025-55234. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability in SMB. This one was publicly disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 8.8 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required here, but user interaction is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this, but there is a little bit more information about this that's available and I want to make you aware of. The code changes here for this CVE allow customers to now audit their environments to identify any potential device or incompatibility issues before deploying SMB hardening measures that can protect against relay attacks. So take a look at this KB article 506-6913 for more information there. But again here, the code changes for this vulnerability now allow customers to go and look in their own environments to determine whether or not there's any kind of issues that could occur before you deploy SMB hardening measures. The affected software is all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether that's Server 2016 up through Server 2025 or Windows 10 and 11 on the desktop side. Next, I'll talk to a vulnerability in Windows NTLM. This is documented as CVE-2025-54918. This is a critical elevation of privilege vulnerability, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 8.8. The attack vectors over the network. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows and mainstream support, whether that's Windows 10 and 11 on desktop or Server 2016 up through Server 2025 on the server side. And the last vulnerability that I'll cover today is CVE-2025-55227. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability in SQL Server. This has a base CVSS score of 8.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required. No user interaction is required to leverage this. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. And an attacker who is able to successfully leverage this would be able to gain sysadmin privileges. As far as the affected software, it's SQL Server 2016, 2017, 2019, and SQL Server 2022. Also point out, it's the latest cumulative update for those products. So if you're using an older cumulative update, the path here is to upgrade your SQL Server to the latest cumulative update and then install this security update. Okay, that's all I have for you today. I want to thank you for joining, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.